Hello students, welcome to JDF with Riya. Today we are going to discuss about the steps of research. Research is a rigorous process that requires a certain code of conduct to be followed. In order to systematically and scientifically carry out this process, one needs to follow a number of steps. These steps entail a series of closely related activities done in a defined way to get accurate findings. Despite it being a scientific process, one should regard research as an art than a science. What indeed makes any research stand out for its finding is defined by how well the whole process has been executed. Following are the main steps involving in research. They are selection of research problem, literature review, making hypothesis, preparing research design, deciding sampling technique, data collection, data analysis, testing the hypothesis, generalization and interpretation, prepare of report or report writing, thesis writing for the purpose of an academic degree. The first is selecting a data. The research process begins with identifying the research problem, a research problem in the area of concern which the researcher has chosen to study. The selection cannot be random, while need a thorough understanding of the problem. Usually in academics, a research problem is the troubling question that exists in literature or theory or our day-to-day life. It's quite important that the research questions or topics should be practical, socially feasible and politically acceptable. More importantly, it should be a topic that primarily interests the researcher undertaking study. The next is literature review. Once we have sorted the research problem, the next step should be to understand the topic well. This requires an extensive literature review. By literature review, we mean the study of all the existing research work that are in some way or other related to our research question. This step also helps to check the volume of work that has been done in the same field. Often a research problem that has no existing literature is toned down further to make it more practical and realistic. The next is making hypothesis. Next step involves the formulation of hypothesis. It is a technical process and requires much precision. Making a hypothesis depends upon the experience and knowledge of the researcher. In the research literature, the hypothesis often referred to an educated guys because it suggested an expected outcome based on evidence. In other words, the hypothesis is a proposed explanation for the phenomenon that need to be tested going forward in a research process. In statistics, the hypothesis is usually written in if-then format. The next is preparing research data. This is another technical step and needs expertise and proficiency. After finalizing the research problem or question and formulation of the hypothesis, the research proceed to prepare the research design. By definition, research design refers to the strategies or a framework that lay down a coherent plan to address the research problem. It can be considered to be a blueprint for the rest of the steps involved in the research process, including data collection, measurement, and data analysis. The next is deciding sampling technique. The next step is about deciding the sampling technique. In research, a sample is a group of people, object or item that can have been picked from the entire population. Sampling can be done random and non-random. Great care should be taken while deciding the sample population and size, as the picked population need to represent the universe. A good sampling technique helps to generalize the findings. Broadly, there are 5 types of sampling method. They are random, systematic, convenient, cluster, and stratified sampling. The next is data collection. This is indeed the most meticulous part of the research process. This involves collecting the information from the respondent or the chosen sample. Data collection can be done in 2 ways, primary and secondary. The primary data collection information is collected directly from the respondents. This is the first-hand knowledge about the population in concern. Primary data collection is done through the method like personal interview, observation, questionnaire, schedule, etc. In secondary data collection, we make explicit use of second-hand information, method like archived memories, biographies, journals are considered part of secondary data collection. The next is data analysis. The analysis of data requires a number of closely related activities that simplify and categorize the collected data. This may include coding, tabulation, editing, and so on. After the required data is collected and processed, it is elucidated through a description, explanation, narration, conclusion, recommendation, and suggestions. These days, researchers make wide use of computer software to analyze the data. The next step is testing the hypothesis. Later, analyzed data is used to test the hypothesis. Hypothesis testing means determining whether the hypothesis assumed for the sample of data stand true or the entire population or not. It is at this step we determine whether the hypothesis has been rejected or accepted. Whether a hypothesis is rejected and accepted is computed statistically. The next is generalization and interpretation. After the hypothesis has been tested, the researcher is in position to generate and make interpretation. It is at this stage the theory can be formulated. The last step is report writing. This is the final step that involves sharing of result or findings in a prescribed format. How a report or thesis is to be written varies from one institution to another. Nonetheless, there are some common sections or parts that should comprise a thesis. Refer to our provisional notes for the comprehension understanding for thesis writing. Okay, that's all for this session. Thank you for watching. Keep watching and keep learning.